Hi, I'm Meris with Level Up RN, and in this video, I'm going to be talking to you about some normal growth and development milestones and expectations for the infant, which is birth to 1 year. I'm going to be following along using our pediatrics flashcards. I'm starting here in the growth and development section. If you have a set of your own already, I would invite you to follow along with me. And if not, check out our website, levelupRN.com, where you can grab a set of your own. All right. Let's get started. Okay, so first up, we are talking about some anthropometric milestones in growth and development for infants. And that means that we're talking about how their body changes and what those measurements are that we expect to see. So you'll see here, we've got something here in bold red text, which means that we think it's pretty important for you to know, but there's a lot more of information on this card, so let's talk about it. When an infant is born, they initially actually lose weight, and that is normal and expected up to about 10% of their birth weight. That's something that we expect to see. However, we expect that the child should be back to their birth weight by 1 week of age. So they should lose weight initially, and then they're going to start breastfeeding or having formula feedings, and then they're going to start to gain weight again. So we should see that by 1 week, they're back to their birth weight. However, by the time a child is 4 to 6 months, we expect to see that they have doubled their birth weight. So if the, let's make up a number, the child is born at 7 pounds, between that 4 to 6 month range, we're expecting the child to be 14 pounds, right? So that's just a general guideline. If we didn't see that being met, that might be something that we investigate further. We also expect that by 1 year of age, at 12 months old, a child should triple their birth weight. So that 7 pound infant at a year old should now be 21 pounds. Okay, it's just math, right? It's not too bad. You just have to memorize those numbers because that does come up a lot in clinical practice in terms of, is my child meeting those guidelines, those milestones? That's one of the big ones that we're going to be looking at. Now, length, we would expect to see that within the first year, they're going to increase their length by 50%. Why don't we call it height? Height is for when you are able to stand to be measured. Length is for when we do it horizontally. And then we would say that for the first 6 months of their life, they're going to gain about 1 inch per month, and then a half an inch per month in the second 6 months. Again, it's just a general guideline, not hard and fast, but that's kind of what we expect to see. Now, head circumference. Remember that we do measure this as part of those anthropometric measurements at a child's pediatric appointments. So the normal head circumference of a full-term infant is going to be 32 to 38 centimeters. And remember, these are pumpkins on broomsticks. So we expect that their head is actually going to have about a 2 centimeter larger diameter than their chest. That is normal. We would never, if my head were 2 centimeters larger than my chest circumference, I would look like a cartoon character, right? So this is normal for children, okay? Very important to understand that that is a normal finding. It will go away with age, though. If the head and chest circumference will be equal to one another approximately at 1 year of age. Okay, let's keep on chugging right along. We are now moving on to talk about fontanelles. If you remember, we talk about fontanelles. Those are those sort of soft spots in the skull that allow an infant to pass through the birth canal because it allows for molding and kind of for those bones to get squished over top of each other and things like that, because it's hard to squeeze a big head through a birth canal, right? Fontanelles help us there. But they don't stick around forever, right? I don't have a fontanelle anymore. That would be really bad. So let's talk about when they close. This is important because if they don't close at the right time, then we can end up with some problems. And you'll see those when we talk about it in the alterations of health videos. But right now, let's just talk about the normals. So posterior fontanelle, this one back here, is going to close between 6 to 8 weeks. Okay, 6 to 8 weeks. Anterior fontanelle, this one up front, is going to close between 12 to 18 months. Okay, big difference in when they close. So we have a cool chicken hint here on the card. Remember, the cool chickens are how we think that you might be able to remember these things, little memory tricks. So we say, just as baby is on her back first, then turns onto her front later, posterior fontanelle closes first, and then anterior fontanelle closes later. I also remember that around that 12 to 18 month range is when a child tends to start walking. And I think about a child falling when they're walking and hitting the front of their head. And that's kind of how I remember that that's around that same age. I don't know if that helps you, but that's how I remember it. All right. Teeth. Teeth are an important thing to talk about. They are a milestone as well. So the first tooth typically erupts or starts to show up in the gum line at about 6 months. It's not hard and fast. It's a general guideline. My daughter didn't get her first tooth until she was 9 months old. My son got his at 5 months old. It's just kind of in that general area. So typically we start with the bottom two teeth here and then move on to the top two teeth. But the infants will have all of their like baby teeth by age three is kind of the thought here. We'll have 6 to 8 of them by age 12 months, all of them by age three. They got a lot of teeth to fill in. It takes time. It's hard work. But you'll see here we have another cool chicken hint, and this one is very important when it comes to guessing a child's age. If you can think about maybe being an emergency room nurse or a pediatric ER nurse, and maybe you have a child who was in a car accident and the parents are, you know, being cared for at another facility, you don't know how old this child is. We have a lot of ways that we can estimate a child's age, but one of them is teeth. So you'll see here our cool chicken hint says the age of the child in months minus 6 should approximately equal the total number of teeth that that child has up to age 24 months, right? So that's an important distinction there. It only works until they're 2 years old. So that means that if I have, let's say, a 12-month-old child, I would expect that they're going to have 6 teeth. Again, it's not hard and fast, it's just a guideline, but it can help you to say this child is around 12 months old. So if I look in their mouth, they have 6 teeth, I'm gonna say 6 plus 6, 12, that they're probably about 12 months old. Okay, moving on, let's talk here. Oh gosh, we have these amazing charts here for you of all of the different reflexes that you have, because there's a lot of reflexes you're born with that don't stick around forever. So in these tables, we have the name of the reflex, the age at which it should disappear, and then a description of that reflex. First up is the Moro or startle reflex. That's when an infant hears a loud noise or a sudden movement, like if you bump into their crib, or sometimes they get the sensation of falling, they will put their arms out, bring them back in, and cry. That is called the Moro reflex. Walking or stepping. If I hold an infant up and have their feet touch on the ground, they will kind of make a stepping motion. It's a protective reflex. They can't actually support their weight though. Rooting. Rooting is the reflex of looking around for food. So essentially looking for a nipple, right, for breastfeeding. And this is going to be that the child, when their face is stroked, they're going to turn their head in that direction looking for food. Sucking reflex. This one is going to be when the lips are touched, the infant begins to suck. Now, Moro should disappear at 2 months along with the stepping reflex, and then rooting and sucking should disappear at 4 months old. Okay, the last one here, this is more reflexes. Palmar grasp. That means when I put something in the palm of the baby's hand, they're going to close their hand and grip it tightly. So very commonly, this is someone seeing a newborn and they put their finger here and they grab on so tight and they say, oh my gosh, she loves me so much. I hate to break it to you, it's a reflex, okay? That should disappear by 5 to 6 months. tonic neck reflex. This is sometimes called fencing position. So this is when the head is turned, the infant is going to extend the arm and leg on the same side while the opposite arm and leg are going to flex inward. So basically, if you turn my head this way, this arm and leg are going to go out and this one is going to come in, and this is kind of fencing position, right? Like if you've ever seen fencers. So that one should disappear by 5 to 7 months. Plantar grasp, same as palmar grasp, except the sole of the foot disappears between 9 to 12 months. And Babinski reflex. Remember, Babinski reflex, we should expect to see a positive Babinski sign up until age 12 months. In an adult, this is an ominous and very bad finding. In a child under the age of 1 year, this is a normal finding. So when the sole of the foot is stroked in an upside down J, we're going to see the toes are going to fan out and dorsiflex. They're going to pull up and fan out. That is normal. All right, I'm gonna ask you some quiz questions to test your knowledge of some key facts I provided in this video. Okay, so you are caring for a child who weighed 6 pounds, 2 ounces at birth. They are in your clinic today for their 6-month checkup. What do you expect their weight to be? So the pediatrician informs a child's caregiver that their 6-week-old infant's fontanelle is beginning to close. Which fontanelle is the provider likely referring to? You're assessing a child and you note that they have 12 teeth. Based on this information, how old do you presume this child to be? You observe that when you place your finger in the palm of a 4-month-old child, that they close their fingers around it and grab it tightly. Two questions here. What is the name of this reflex, and is it normal for this 4-month-old to be displaying it? All right, let me know how you did in the comments. I'm excited to hear how you managed on those quiz questions. Thanks so much and happy studying.
I invite you to subscribe to our channel and share a link with your classmates and friends in nursing school. If you found value in this video, be sure to hit the like button and leave us a comment and let us know what you found particularly helpful.